each of you received this grant. Can you talk a little bit about how it may or may not have been an inflection point in your career and what it might have meant had you not had this funding when you got it?
So you might have been able to tell from the introduction for me that the word cancer was actually not in it. My secret is out. I'm actually not a cancer biologist. I'm an immunologist. So I study immune cells, and one of the things that was really exciting about this grant from the Cancer Research Foundation was it enabled me to start a program of applying my expertise in immunology to solve problems in cancer. And so the work that was funded through this Cancer Research Foundation was to look at a particular type of immune cell and how it might potentiate the risk of obese women to develop triple-negative breast cancer. And this sparked a large effort in my lab. Multiple projects spawned from this, looking at other immune contributions. And some of the most interesting work that we've been doing currently, which is not directly related to my grant, was we've identified these cancer-killing proteins, which we've shown have been able to kill, now tested 27 different types of human cancer cell lines, whether it's prostate or breast or lung. The genetics of these cancer cells don't matter. Our proteins are able to kill these cancer cells within 2 hours. However, when we put these proteins on non-cancer cells, there's almost no toxicity. So we think we found this amazing set of proteins that has this ability to kill cancer cells selectively, irrespective of their genetics. And as I mentioned, this is not directly coming from the Cancer Research Foundation work, but that grant was instructed